Hi viewer, I welcome you to Dream TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through business studies for men, lesson number 20. The topic it is entrepreneurship. I'm your tutor, Lucy Mothon. Welcome. Let us look at our lesson objectives. Today we are going to look at the business opportunities. So by the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to explain the business opportunities. And also, I write where we have the business gaps, like that. So when we are looking at the business opportunities, after the looking at the business ideas, now we are in the business opportunities. That is what you are going to do today. Business opportunity. Business opportunity is favorable chance that an entrepreneur accepts for investment. What is that chance? Chance that you accept. Yes, after having business ideas, what have you accepted? What have you decided to take? It exists where there is a gap to be filled in the market. So there must be that business gap that must be there in the market for the business opportunity to arise. Now let us look at the business gaps. Now when I talk about business gaps, before I go to the indicators of the business gap, it is a business that is not provided in a given price, or a service that is not provided in a given price. It is necessary, but it is not there. Yes, it is there, but it is not of right quality. So what do we do? What are the indicators that there is that business gap? One, in availability of the product it is not produced in the area, it is not available. In the area, for example, when we talk about a business gap of the spare parts in a certain place, it means that there are the mechanics, there are the availability of the cars, availability of the motorcycles. Then, but there is inability, or there is no presence of the spare parts. They are going to get it in another market, in another place, or in another site. Then it means that there is that gap. Then the poor quality products. This, for example, of the foodstuffs. You happen to get into an hotel, and you happen to get the hotels in that place, they are producing poor quality. Then it means that if at all improve the quality, you can have that business. So there is that business gap of provision of good quality product. Number three, insufficient quantities. If at all they are inadequate or they are not enough. Then number four, unaffordable prices. Prices, yes, the goods are there, but their prices, those who are selling, they are selling at a high price. So you can offer at fair prices. Then poor services. You can be able to see how we have the business ideas, the structure, the system, the staff, the shared vision. You share it, the opportunity. Then you can also see the market shares, the ones that we have. They are there. You want to be at that point, you are here, so you are trying to increase. You have that gap analysis. Evaluating a business opportunity. This means assessing whether the identified opportunity is viable or not. It helps in arriving at the best decision concerning the business idea to implement. Evaluation should be done carefully, systematically, and without emotions. You should be relaxed. You do it emotionally, systematically. and carefully. Personal and business consideration are the key factors that are put into account when carrying out business opportunity evaluation. What are you feeling? How is the business going to be? Those are when it comes to evaluation. Personal decisions, considerations. One, we look at the objective. What are your aims? What do you intend to provide? Skills. What skills do you have as an entrepreneur? What can you offer yourself without even employing people? So the skills you can do. Number three, entrepreneur's commitment. Are you committed or you're committed in other businesses? Then number four, entrepreneur's interest. Are you interested in it? Is it your hobby? Assignments. Explain the factors to consider when starting a business. Number two, explain the factors to consider for the success of the business. For reference, visit the KJB 2011 Inventor Secondary Business Student Book 1, that edition. If at all you have any question, additional information, you can get us through the SMS. You can also get us from the YouTube. You can also get us from the Facebook, and you can Twitter us. Thank you. Stay tuned to EdimTV.